For this another 2 minutes, I will share something about what I have experienced when it comes to career. Good morning, Munira. Good morning, Rangaya, Ramesh. Yeah. I would share my personal experience till Ali starts the talk for today. I did my DCS, Diploma in Counseling Skills, in 2008. And after that, I didn't know where to restart my life. I did a lot of things before, but was not happy with what I was doing. And once I completed my DCS, again I was at the same crossroad, that where do I start from now? After understanding my aptitude or my qualities, everything, but I still didn't know where to start from. And that was the time I gave my aptitude test at Banjara. That gave me a path to move on with a very satisfying time spent at Banjara, doing work what is I'm good at, what is satisfying for me, and which I can keep on doing. It doesn't stress me. Other things do stress me, but not the work of what I do. That is something I would say. And I think I was 40, around 40 by then, 40 plus. That's the time I changed my career. So I think age is something doesn't matter when you want to do something what you are good at and what you like it. So over to the hero of the day today.
I don't know whether I'm a hero or a zero.
You
because
are.
One thing is there, that I have still not been able to find my career. I still keep changing. Sometimes I think I'm a writer, sometimes I think I'm a trainer, sometimes I think I'm a counselor, sometimes I even feel that I am a farmer and I should go away to Manthan and sit and do farming and stuff like that. But I think that is one of the reasons why I'm qualified to be able to be talking to you people. The only regret is that I'm doing this talk in that little 6-inch thing. I would have loved to spend time with you all in a nice crowded hall as we used to have whenever we have our, you know, helping hand talks or Banjara's lectures, to the extent that there would be people who would be sitting squatting on the stage and there would be people standing near the door and we would all be having a lovely time. Because I remember many years back there was this lady who came to inquire and say that I want to do DCS, Diploma in Counseling Skills. So I asked her, good, we explained everything, of course, the details and all that. But after that, I asked her, which we generally do, that after doing this course, what do you want to do with it? How do you want to proceed further? And she said that I want to quit my job and I want to become a full-time counselor. Fine. I said, what job are you doing right now? And I was amazed to hear that not only she was a software engineer, but in a short span of a few years, she had been immensely successful. She had achieved a lot. She was drawing an astronomical salary. She had a very respected position in her organization, and she had a reputation and the work that she is doing. She used to be flying in and out of the, you know, many countries and all that. I said, do you want to give up all this for the uncertainty of being a full-time counselor? You don't even know how much salary you will get and what sort of opportunities you will get. Why do you want to give up something so lucrative? And I'll never forget what she said. She said, sir, I want to see that there is a world beyond that 17-inch screen of my laptop. So I thought, that should be the theme of today, because there is a world outside the 66-inch mobile phone in which you are probably watching me. There's a world outside the 17-inch laptop screen, if some of you are watching on that. There is a whole wide world. If you still have doubts, do something that I do on a regular basis. Just before sunset, I climb up to my terrace, sometimes with a cup of tea or something like that, and sit down and watch the birds. Oh my God, you should see the variety of birds. Even in a concrete jungle like Bangalore City, You should see the number of birds that we see. And the beauty of it is, they are all happy, soaring in the skies. They are not sitting and wondering whether my job is secure or not, and how much savings have I got, and what promotion I will get, and how do I face my boss, and things of that sort. Okay. That was only a beside. Let me come to the main topic. What is important is for us to understand, starting with the fact that when we say career, please understand that career is not the same as job. In a particular career, I may be doing 20 different jobs. I may be moving from one job to another. I may be moving from one designation or one, you know, specific activity to another. I may be, you know, moving laterally into using my domain specialization skills in different ways. But unfortunately, people, many of them, are still stuck to the concept of job. Starting with one thing, you know that I'm a career counselor, I write this column in Deccan Herald and some other publications and all these things, and we have our own, you know, website, My Counselor, where people write and ask various questions, including for careers. I am amazed that people ask, please let me know which is the degree that I can take, which will get me the best job opportunities and highest salaries. And the next question they ask is, and also tell me which is the college which has got the best campus recruitment. Now, which degree will get you the best salary, nobody can predict. What you get out of your campus recruitment is not going to be of any help to you, because surveys have shown that most professionals who take up the campus recruitment jobs stick to that first job for an average of 1.3 years. Now, what is your total working span? It is a minimum of 50 years. You complete your studies normally at the age of 22, 24, 26, 28, whatever number of degrees also if you take up. And from, let's say, an average of 25. From 25 to 75 is minimum 50 years that you are going to be working in the career that you have selected. Retirement age for today's generation is not going to be 58 or 60. It is going to be somewhere in the region of 75 to 80. When I tell this to youngsters, you know, they say, oh, who wants to work till that? I don't know whether I'll be alive or not. Fine. If you're not going to be alive, you obviously don't have to worry about your career. But if you are alive, have you planned for it? The way people plan their finances, for example, that as I grow old and when I cannot earn, I should be having some savings and some income, which will help me to see me through my days of the old age where I may not be able to earn money, isn't it? We plan all that, isn't it? The same way we need to plan with regard to our careers. So please understand that when I talk about career, I am talking about what they are referring to nowadays as domain specialization. You have specialized in which domain? That is what is a career. I am a software programmer. I am a qualified legal professional. I am an architect. I am a plumber or carpenter. I am a qualified teacher. These are what we refer to as domain specializations. So you acquire a particular domain specialization, and generally it comes through the studies that you have done, or at least it is supposed to. But here again comes a very, very funny anomaly. Whatever you are studying, you will realize that what you study in college gets outdated in 5 years, 10 years maximum, and then you still have another 40 years to go. One of the top office bearers of the Chartered Accountants Association, they had invited me last year for their annual conference. So when I was talking to him, very eminent and a very successful chartered accountant with more than 25 years experience and things of that sort, and an office bearer of their association. He was telling me that my son is currently studying to become a chartered accountant. But I find that I cannot help him at all in his studies because what he is studying is totally alien to me. What I had studied has gone completely outdated. So one of the top-notch practicing chartered accountants says that I cannot teach my son because the curriculum is so different. So this is what I want you to understand. The same thing applies in technology, same thing applies in medicine, same thing applies in anything that you choose to do. That yes, you do need qualifications. You do need your degrees and diplomas to have that foundation. And once you have done that, you use that as a foundation to move towards what we will call as our domain specialization. Some of us, and I can tell you it's a minority, stick to whatever they have learnt in college. So people who have done software engineering say that, yes, I will continue to be a software engineer as long as I work. But I also know of people who have studied biotechnology engineering, found that there isn't proper campus placement for biotechnology engineers, learnt a little bit of software, got into a software company, and today they are very successful software engineers, competing with those who spent 4 years learning software engineering. So taking that into account, please do understand that your basic education, your qualifications are a foundation. They are not the end all and be all. Just because you are qualified in a particular field does not mean that you have to do that for the rest of your life. Just before I started, Sonal was talking to you. Do you know what she has qualified as? She is a qualified lawyer and advocate. She also holds that badge or whatever it is that she can put on that black coat and go and say, "Yes, Your Honor," and she can do that even today if she wants to. But she doesn't want to. In young age, we generally, most of us, get pushed into something without realizing the consequences of what, where, how, and things of that sort. No regrets. Once you start moving into your career, you have acquired some qualification, you have taken up your job, don't get carried away by the fact that I'm earning so much money and I'm already qualified in this. Have a vision. Look a little beyond what is happening today. Talk to people who have completed their study 10 years, 20 years, 30 years back. Take a survey, take a mini survey. It's not very difficult among your known people. You will be amazed that majority of the people are not doing anything even remotely connected to what they studied in college. They are doing something which is totally different. And the beauty of it is they are successful in what they are doing. How does that happen? That happens because a good education makes your foundation stronger. You need a strong foundation to do what you want. Once you make, let's say you want to construct a house or flat or bungalow or apartments or mall or theater or auditorium or whatever you want to build, you have to have first a foundation. That foundation ensures that the building will stay in one place. It will not sink, it will not crack, it will not topple over. So you go deep down, you check the soil, you see how deep it has to go, you put the pillars and these and whatever has to be done. And when the foundation is strong, on the same foundation, you can build a house, you can build an apartment, you can build a theater, you can build a factory, you can build anything that you want, isn't it? So now you have your basic qualification. Regardless of what field that qualification is, it doesn't matter. If you go back to see my classmates, my batchmates, people who are plus or minus in those, my contemporaries, you would say, they are people who studied what we call, as many of you may not even have heard of it, it is called metallurgical engineering. In fact, now it's you know, outdated, because they have even removed that. Now they have made it materials engineering. In those days, there was this branch of engineering called metallurgical engineering, and many of us took to it. And we passed out of a prestigious institution of engineering, the IIT in Bombay. 30-40 years have gone past. Barring a handful of what we refer to as nerds, none of them are doing anything which is remotely connected to metallurgy. But the beauty of it is that most of them are enjoying what they do. Many of them are successful also in inverted commas. Some of them are not. I also know of people who are not earning big money, nowhere close to what they should be earning as IIT graduates. But they are satisfied and happy people. That is what is a career all about. Is your career going to make you happy or not? Right. So, let's say you are at some crossroads where you need to select your career. It could be because you are in 10th standard and you have to decide whether you want to take science, commerce, arts, etc. It could be because you are in 12th standard and you want to decide, now that I'm completing my second PU, what degree course should I take up and how should I proceed further. It could be because you have qualified yourself with a basic degree and now you are wondering whether to study higher or to take up a job or to get into some management field or whatever it is. It could be because you already worked for a few years in whatever capacity you have, and now you are questioning, where am I headed? Am I in the right direction? Should I look for something different? It could be because you are in some sort of a midlife crisis. You worked for 10, 15, 20 years in a particular field. You even made a success of it. But you're not very happy. You're questioning, is this what I would be doing the rest of my life? Is my life meant only to be earning more and more money and just going up the ladder or something of that sort? It could be because you have retired. Superannuation, which still continues to be at 58, 60, whatever it is. So however good you are, if you're in a organized setup at 60 years of age, you are told, here, take this wristwatch and a farewell party and go home. So you're wondering, what do I do with myself? I'm healthy, fit, fine. I can work for minimum 10, 20 years more. I don't want to sit at home. So what do I do now? And then, of course, there is this huge segment of these wonderful, great Indian women who have studied hard, who have acquired qualifications. Some of them have even worked for a few years very successfully, but have eventually given up their career for the sake of their family and for the sake of their children. Now, at some point or the other, they will realize that their family and their children don't need them as much as they were, you know, needed a few years back. So, what do I do? Can I restart my career? Lot of people put them down. Hey, as it is, there is a recession, there is a lockdown, there is these. Where you'll get a job? People who have been working hard with so many years of experience also are not getting jobs. Where will you get a job? I don't agree. That's the beauty of it. The way the world economy and the way the, you know, globalization and so many things have happened. Opportunities are coming for people everywhere at any time. Now, what you need to do is to stop being complacent. Stop being in that rut where, you know, you're just moving on without realizing where you are, you know, headed. If you can do that, you will realize that you can start exploring outside. Do you have a vision when you think of yourself when you are 70 years or 80 years old? What would you be doing? Very few of us can even vaguely visualize what we will be doing when we are 60, 70, 80 or whatever it is. But that's what you need to do. Do I select a career where I can continue working happily even when I become a little weak, even if I cannot commute long distances and I can't take that, you know, hectic 24/7 schedule, but I will have my domain specialization which will see me through. So do you have that little vision? That is extremely important. You have to have that. The other thing is that are you upgrading yourself? As I mentioned just now, all formal studies, even at the best of training institutions, colleges, universities, gets outdated very fast. Are you upgrading yourself? Some of you may be doing. See, we are in an era where distance learning, open universities and all that have offered the best of possible things to do, which was not there 20 years back. So even if you are in a good job, good career, whatever it is, are you looking beyond to see what else can I do? How can I upgrade myself? Can I acquire more formal qualifications as in degrees and diplomas? Or do I just want to learn for myself? After the coming of MOOC, M-O-O-C, massive online open courses, some of the top-notch universities of USA, top-notch universities of India are offering MOOC courses. Many of them are free. Some of them, they charge a nominal amount. But if you can latch on to MOOC courses without disturbing your routine, you will automatically be upgrading yourself. There's another factor which I want you to please give a serious thought to. You know, we have this left brain and right brain type of thing. Some of us are into very logical, analytical, mathematical, sequential type of thinking and work. Some of us are more on the creative side. Some of us are on the emotional side. Some of us are on the interpersonal side, etc. Now, regardless of where you are and what you are, can you start taking interest, even at a casual level, in things which do not concern you at all? Into areas where, which have got nothing to do with your working life or your profession or your career. So if you are doing, let's say, accounts work, you are a commerce and accounts and, you know, that sort of a person. Can you look into the world of people or, you know, design or creativity or emotions or something of that sort? Can you look into the world of technology and see what's happening over there? So one of the things that I would request you, regardless of what your age and status and position in life is, I would request you to please start taking interest, at least casually, at least in a free time, on weekends, in areas which have nothing to do with your profession. Two things will happen. One is, tomorrow, if there is a need for you to bring about a change in career, job, whatever it is, your thinking would be much wider than what it is now. You will be able to evaluate, you have seen the world. It's like a person who has traveled all over the world, and today if he decides that I want to move to a new country, it is so easy for him because he has seen, you know, the whole world, and he can decide very easily where he can go. So please do that. There's a second reason also why I'm telling you. As I mentioned to you, longevity is continuously increasing. Today, many, many, many of you can aspire to hit a century. COVID or no COVID, it's very likely that many of you would be 90, 95, 100 years old before you kick the bucket. But you can make a bucket list right now. You don't have to wait till then. So if you start using all parts of your brain, if you start thinking, dabbling in areas which are not connected to what your profession is, your brain will remain active. See, when the body keeps deteriorating after 70, 80, 90, continuously you will see the body becoming less and less agile. But if your brain remains active, today technology will take care of all the limitations of the body. Everything can be done through robots or computers or these artificial intelligence, internet of things and stuff like that. But your brain has to be active. Research has shown that people who use all parts of the brain, you know, like a technology person who is also interested in music, or a lawyer who also, you know, dabbles in understanding emotions of people. Anybody like that, the more you use all parts of your brain, the less are the chances that your brain will atrophy and you will end up with, you know, dementia or Alzheimer's disease or something. So this is another investment that you are making for your future and your old age, looking beyond. Even in your own organization, if there are people who are doing different work, in your free time, go and sit with them and chat up and ask them, what's the type of work that you are doing? What are the skills required? What are the thinking patterns that you have to follow? Outside your office, talk to people wherever you can meet them. On weekends, try as far as possible to spend time with people who are not from your profession and not doing the same type of work. This will really help you. That brings me to one serious question. At one point, you had to take, or you have taken, a decision that after, you know, 10th standard, I will take up arts or I'll take up science. Then when you finished your 12th, you said that I will study this particular degree course. Whatever it is, you took those decisions. Now, regardless of what your age is and the type of work that you are doing, including, as I mentioned, even if you are a full-time homemaker, somewhere along the time, the question starts slowly popping up, what next? You start questioning the purpose of your life. If it has not happened to you now, I assure you that it is going to happen one day or the other. You will just wake up on a lazy day when you don't have any work and you will sit and think and say, where am I headed? What am I doing? Yes, I'm successful. I have such and such designation. I have this salary, or I'm taking care very beautifully of my family and my children, or whatever it is. But what next? How am I going to take my life forward in future? When you need to go, even think about this, generally what happens is complacency sets in. People say, I'm comfortable with what I am doing, so why do I even need to think beyond? It is like the person who says, I have this house or this building and everything is fine in this house. There is no threat to it. Only if a fire breaks out, then I will go running to the market and buy a fire extinguisher and come and try to douse the fire. Does it work that way? No. If you want to take precautions, you have to buy a fire extinguisher and keep it handy. You don't know when the fire is going to break out. So the same little bit of caution that I want to give you, I will not call it a warning, but definitely a caution that I want to give you is, with the way world is changing, you don't know when you will have to take a decision. Just 6 months back, some of the most lucrative professions where people were doing exceedingly well have suddenly collapsed. Not only in the short run, many of them are permanently closing down or getting away from that profession because they say, even if it picks up, it's going to take such a long time that I cannot survive. I cannot wait for it to pick up. Now, 6 months back when they were complacent, if they could have sat down and thought, in case I can't continue in this profession or this job or this type of activity that I'm doing, what else would I do? They didn't think of that. Now is the time to think. In case I have to change, let's say you are one of the fortunate ones who have not been affected by the lockdown. You have your job, you have your income, you have your stability, you have everything going. Can you give a guarantee that it will remain the same way 6 months or 6 years from now? You cannot, no? So understand that any crisis can come at any time. If you were resistant to that type of thinking, I'm sure the coronavirus has shaken you up enough to help you to think that yes, anything can happen to anybody at any time, and it can be a global phenomenon. Earlier, people used to say, if I don't get a job in India, I will migrate to America and I'll take up a job there. Probably there are a lot of Americans thinking now that, can I migrate to India and take up a job there because chances of my earning are better over there. So you need to please think a little beyond, a little further ahead. Because I am a strong believer that you should bring about a change when there is no pressure on you. So as I told you, let's say you are a complacent, happy homemaker, housewife. One day your children are going to fly out of the nest. You'll start getting bored. You start getting restless. Your self-esteem will go down. What am I doing? I'm doing nothing. Before that happens, plan ahead. Explore. 5 years from now, 10 years from now, my life is going to be different. So what am I going to do at that stage? At least let me have some clarity on that. So bring about a change. Explore a different world when there is no pressure on you to change. Because I am watching, right now I am watching day in and day out, people who suddenly lose their job and then they panic and they say, what do I do now? I never thought I'll be losing my job. I have been working so hard for so many years. I have such a good track record that I never thought that I am going to lose my job. But it has happened. Now I can't even think straight. And people like that take wrong decisions. They take impulsive decisions. And they land up from the frying pan to the fire. So my request to you is to look for change, plan for the future when there is no pressure. When you have not lost your job, or when there is no threat to your job or anything of that sort, that's the time to think about the future. And one very important thing, please remember, when you want a change, you should have a positive and optimistic viewpoint, saying that I want to go for something better. People who want to run away from something inevitably land up from the frying pan into the fire. I hate my job, so I want to quit and take up something new. I hate the type of work that I am doing. It's so routine, monotonous, boring, so I want to quit and get into something new. Worse than that, I hate my boss, so I want to get out and I want to do something new. Now, people who think negatively that I am not happy and therefore I want to do something or the other, they never land up in the right situation. Please remember that as a very basic formula for life, that you do not run away from something, you run towards something. I am happy, I am not happy, I have got ups and downs, I like my boss, I hate my boss, I have got so many other things. Can I sit down and say, can I make my life a little better? What is it that I can do to ensure that my life continues to improve? The work environment continues to improve. The type of work that I am doing becomes a little more attractive to me than what it is today. So when you start thinking that I want to move for something better, believe me, you do find it. Coming to somewhere near the end of the thing, because after that I'll be having an open house, I'll be answering your questions. Please do not make that change and select based on what I keep hearing, this funny word all the time, scope. Every day I get inquiries from people, sir, tell me which career has got the best scope. I say, I don't know. Periscope, microscope, what scope are you talking about? There is no such thing as scope. You are good in something, you will be successful and you will earn money. you are not good in something, even if there are 1,000 jobs available, you will either not get it or you will take it up and you will be miserable for the rest of your life. It has to be selected. Career has to be selected. Career change has to be brought in based on what you like and what you want to do and what you are good at. It should be a combination of your skills, your interest, your aptitude, your financial and holding ability, your personality traits. All that should be brought into account when you take a decision about what new thing that you are going to do. And it should also not be escapist. Another 5 years I'll work very hard, I'll make a lot of money, and then I'll go to some village and I will do farming. Believe me, farming is 10 times more difficult than whatever job you are doing right now. More stressful, more physically and mentally strenuous. It's not an escape. Life doesn't have those type of escapes. So when you are thinking of change, it should be, as I said, something very, very positive and based on what you are good and where you would like to move on to. These are some of the very, very simple things which I thought I will share with you. There's a whole world out there. Careers is something which is very close to my heart. I've been doing it for the second generation. I've been guiding people who come to me and say that I want you to please assess my child and to guide my child to do this thing. And then if I ask, you know, how come you came and how do you know me? He says 25 years back when I was a student or when I was wanting to select my career or whatever it is, I had come to you and you had guided me. I'm not trying to boast or something of that sort. It gives me a lot of, you know, satisfaction with the humility that one generation has passed by and there's another generation coming in. The same thing will happen to you. You will see generations going past. Life is going to be elaborate. Life is going to offer you a lot of variety. Scope will go up and down 10 times during your working career. Pandemics will come and go. Once they are over, everybody sits back and laughs at it. While it is on, they think it is the end of the world. In fact, any pandemic like this, any lockdown like this, should be a good opportunity for you to please take up seriously these questions like career. Maybe career for the, you know, person who is earning for this family. Maybe career for the person who is stopped, you know, working outside the house and is committed herself full time to taking care of the family. Maybe it is a career about your child. And this is not just children who are in 10th or 12th. Even if your child is in 2nd standard or 5th standard, start talking careers to your child. Let your child slowly start becoming aware what is the variety of things that can be done. Otherwise, I come across brilliant students who have scored 90% in their 10th or 12th. If I tell them, just list down the number of careers that are the option that are open to you, they can't go beyond 5 or 10. That is what I want you to check out and start working on, regardless of anything. Even if you've got a father or mother at home who has retired and is saying that I'm too old to do something, sit down with them and say, hey, you got enough life ahead of you, you're fit and fine. Why don't you think of some career? And there, when I say career, it need not be taking a job or going to an office or earning money. Career can be far beyond that. Career could be a lot of things which you can do without straining yourself and without being part of that corporate world or anything of that sort. So keeping these very fundamental things in mind, I would now like to take up the questions. Yes, Sonal, go ahead.
Harsha Bardhan is asking, ever since I finished my engineering in electronics almost a decade ago, I did not have a timely career break apparently because I could not finish my graduation on time. I had to venture in and out of different professions from hardware and networking to digital marketing. I am now feeling that I am getting older and simply worried about not doing anything. I badly need to look for some job which brings me pleasure and money. I hope I would be getting some help from you in future.
Yes, Harshvardhan, you can get back to me in future. We will have a one-to-one talk. We will explore and find out what is happening, why you have felt this way. But I just like to say one thing to Harshvardhan and all of you there. You don't badly need to look for a job. You nicely look for a job. The moment we start talking in pessimistic terms, I am growing older, 10 years out of college is not at all older. I know of 75-year-olds who are still making career plans. So whenever you take up a pessimistic attitude, I'm falling behind, I'm getting too old, I badly need a job, automatically your thinking capacity goes down. As I told you, the world is opening out, pandemic or no pandemic, things are going to improve. Be patient and start looking around. So people like Harshvardhan, what I'm saying is that while you have done random, you know, bouncing from one place to another, I tried out this, I tried out that. What we will do now is to sit with you and explore what you are genuinely good at, that you, what you have a passion for, where your interest lies, and that is where we will get the answers. Next question, Sonal.
Yeah, Venkatesh DK, he says, I have had a career in media and communications for more than 20 years and currently keen on shifting my career goal to counseling and life skills. Kindly advise.
Yes, Venkatesh, you have already been in media, you have understood some amount of, you know, human behavior, obviously. You had to analyze people. So there is a foundation, there is a base which you have already established. Now, there will be a lot of questions because you have got 20 plus years of experience. So I presume that you are in a responsible phase of your life, starting with one basic question that can I afford to give up whatever earnings I have for the time being and get back into something where I'll probably be having to start at an entry level? If so, now that I've taken a decision to move away from something which I am very successful at, while counseling is one of the areas which has interested me, I will keep that as option A, but I will also explore option B, option C, option D before I come to this. I'm not going to jump straight into counseling because from a distance it looks very attractive to me. Once I come into it, I may realize that I'm made for it or not. This is the same thing. In fact, right now our admissions for the DCS new batch is going on. Whenever somebody comes to inquire about the course, we inquire about them. And we tell them that please don't mind that we are asking you these few questions because we want to ensure that this course is actually going to help you to make a better life. If it doesn't, we are not interested in just numbers and enrolling you just for the heck of it. So these are the type of things which Harshvardhan and many others need to do. It can be done. Yes, it requires a little bit of hand-holding, a little bit of, you know, guidance from people like us or anybody else whom you know who is competent and who can help you. We will definitely take it forward.
Okay. Now, Sri Ram says, when a person is very impulsive in his decisions, how can he or she can find out an alternative career?
Yeah. Stop your impulses first. You know, train your mind. I told you, that let's say somebody is very impulsive and says, I want to get into counseling or I want to get into data sciences or I want to get into design or something. Yes, fine. That's your impulsive thought. Write it down. Keep it as one of the options. And then say, what else can I do? What could be plan B, plan C, plan D, plan E? Once I've done that, I come back to my original option and I ask myself, how much homework have I done? Do I know what this is all about? Have I explored it enough? And after I've got all the information, have I matched those requirements to my own capabilities? So you need to pull down that impulsiveness and say, this is a decision which is a lifelong decision. I am not, in this particular case, I am going to curb my impulsive tendencies to jump into something just because this looks attractive or something. If you can't do it, have a family member or a mentor or advisor. And tell that person that please stop me when I'm taking some impulsive decision. So you be there for me and, you know, hold me back and say, yes, what you are thinking is fine, but let us wait and see. Let's not be in a hurry. and you will find eventually that you will move in the right direction.
Okay, this is Nallapur Madhavi from Hyderabad. She has done her MA in political science, and later she is done her counseling psychologist, but pursuing B.Ed. special education in learning difficulty.
Wonderful.
She is very passionate about what she is doing. She is liking her work.
Yeah.
But still, always she is on what next, what next.
Yes, Madhavi, I think if this question of what next is coming to you, then you may be enjoying your work at a superficial level, but perhaps, I'm just doing guessing with you, perhaps you are not so deep into it that you can look upon it from a long-term basis. See, there are certain things which I want to do and which I enjoy. I may like to eat an ice cream and I thoroughly enjoy eating that ice cream. But I can't keep eating ice cream the whole day. So while I eat that ice cream and I enjoy it, I'm going to ask myself, what else am I going to eat for the rest of the day? What gives me nutrition? What gives me good taste? What gives is affordable? I look into all those factors and then I plan out, yes, for lunch I'll have this, or for dinner or snacks, I will have that. So as I told earlier, I would say the same thing to Madhavi. Since you are happy right now, and since you are contented, and since you are doing very meaningful work, you've already trained yourself as a counselor and a special educator, which is a wonderful combination. You're working with families where there are children with special needs. It's a very fulfilling and satisfying thing. This is the thing to now ask yourself, 1 year from today, 10 years from today, what do I want to be doing? So if I want to be doing something different, then start exploring what are those different things and how I can move on to something better. And as I said, if you can't do it by yourself, take the help of some experts or guidance or whatever it is. We are also there. Banjara's whole team is there to help you, guide you. But if you have anybody else already known to you, go by that.
Yeah, she even says she is happy with what she is doing with good students, but not earning good money.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
There again, you know, it's certain priorities have to be done. Do I really need more money, or is it just for my satisfaction? If so, plan ahead. 1 year from now, 5 years from now, what am I expected to be earning? If I find that I am hitting a dead end, even 5 years, 10 years down the line, I think I will not be earning much more than what I am. And this is not really giving me the full satisfaction. I feel that I am worthy of earning more. Then, as I said, we start looking laterally. We keep this as a good foundation. But you say that now I will move into something which will get me a little better income, a little more sense of satisfaction.
Here there is Vrinda who says, I love traveling. So what are the options for me for career in traveling?
If you had asked this question in February, my answer would have been different. If you ask me now, the answer is completely different. Possibly if you ask me this question in February 2021, when a vaccine has been found and COVID has been thrown out of the world, my answer is going to be different. Many of us love traveling. But what you need to understand is that, do you want to make travel, tourism as a career? Or do you want to take up any career which you are suited for and which you have the aptitude for and which you can earn money and decide to travel in your work? Anybody, an architect can travel, a lawyer can travel, a doctor can travel if you have that bug and if you have that desire. So you say that I'm not going to restrict myself only to my office or my place of work. I will take up assignments, I'll take up challenges, I'll take up some training programs or whatever it is in different places. So I learn to travel. So I get that benefit of enjoying the travel and I continue with whatever profession that I'm doing. So decide between these two factors and then go ahead.
Yeah, there's Anjali Saxena. She says, I've done my DPCS from Banjara and want to pursue my career in counseling, but I feel I have to upgrade my skills in counseling.
Yes, Anjali.
Please guide me.
Yes, Anjali. One is, of course, when it comes to upgrading, we are there to tell you what all you can do. We had given you that booklet when you passed out about what are the possible areas. Now you have to ask yourself, in that we have systematically listed out, do you want to get back full time into studies and into classroom courses and all that? Do you want to do something by distance education? Do you want to do something by short term courses or workshops and things of that sort? Depending on the time available to you, your flexibility, your economic or financial status, all that has to be decided. But if nothing else, I can tell you, feels like counseling. You definitely learn much more by hands-on than by anything else. Ask any of the successful and senior counselors, they'll tell you that every day I am learning something new. From whom? From my counselees. I spend a lot of time counseling people, and every new person who comes to me for counseling widens my thinking, opens new doors, sharpens my skills and my qualities.
This Spurti Raghu, she says, my son has completed class 10 now. Not sure what is the right step forward. Thinking of opting for commerce, not sure if that would be appropriate.
Right, Spurti. I come back to what I told in the beginning. First, try and set long-term goals for your son. Help him to understand what is the type of work that he will be doing well. Is he a left brain, a logical, mathematical, analytical person? Is he going to be good in technology and stuff like that? Or is he a mathematical person who will be good in accounting, chartered accountancy, banking, insurance, stock markets, all those type of things? Is he a people-oriented person that he may be doing very good in, let's say, marketing or sales or training other people or being in public life or being a lawyer and those sort of things? Is he more of a creative person? So based on that, if you can at least help him to narrow down to some extent what would be the overall field in which he is going to be, based on that you work backwards and say, to reach that goal, would science be better, commerce be better, arts be better, including which board to take up. If he has already done in ICSE or CBSE, should he continue in that, change over to some other board or something of that sort? All those decisions can be based on where the direction in which we are heading, which is the ultimate goal. And as I mentioned, if you cannot do it by yourself, take the help of experts. You can consult us. We give free counseling for career guidance. You can call us up, particularly after Wednesday, if the lockdown is lifted up, my career team will also be here. You can call us up during the daytime. We'll give you whatever guidance. And only in the case that a child needs to be assessed and an aptitude test has to be done, we charge for that. Otherwise, we'll give you free advice and we'll continue to do the hand-holding.
Yes, there's Sunil Kumar here. He says, thanks a lot. It was a great talk and very helpful. But I have a question.
Yes.
I know I want to change my career from IT, but I'm not able to envision my life. Not able to figure out how I want to live. And that blocks me from choosing alternative.
That's right. Take it slow. Now, right now, you are already in the IT field. You are earning your money. You have a position. So there's no pressure. There's no hurry on that. Start thinking. If I had all the time in the world and if I did not have the constraints of my job or my profession or whatever it is, what do I love to do? As I said, no, you can at least generally find out. Am I a people person? Would I love to be interacting and talking to new people all the time? Or on the other side, I can't convince people, I can't be in marketing and law and all those type of things. But I love to understand people, analyze them, understand their emotion. Then maybe I can move into psychology, counseling, any of those, social work, all those type of fields. Or am I a creative person? Am I this? Am I that? You can really find out. Once you have done that and you have some idea, then we'll talk about whether you need to upgrade your skills, as I mentioned earlier, whether you need to do some courses, which you can do probably while you're still working without hampering your earning and things like that. Once you do that, then slowly you can start taking baby steps that, okay, in my free time or weekends, I'll be taking up this work and getting a hands-on experience. Then maybe I'll take a sabbatical from the work that I'm doing and test the waters and see whether I'm good at the thing. And eventually I'll move into something which I'm not only good at, but I will also enjoy.
Okay, this is Manisha Gulecha.
Yes, Manisha.
She says, it's been 15 years since I have completed my master's in counseling. but I have no confidence. How do I upgrade myself now? Is it a long time? Is it a long gap?
Not at all, Manisha. These are things which, if you have that genuine interest in human beings, if you are the type of person who got into the masters in psychology and this and that, with the intention that I would love to interact with and understand people, reach out to people, if your intention has been that. But for whatever reasons, you were busy with other commitments and this and that, you could not actually practice and become a professional in this field. It is definitely not too late. But perhaps what you will need to do is to upgrade yourself, to revise and get back into whatever, you know, the skills that are required. So sharpen your skills again. Get into an entry level position or even a voluntary work or something. Don't worry about the position and salary and all that at this juncture. Get into something where you will get opportunities to work and to sharpen your skills. There are lots of opportunities. We can discuss about that one to one. And then slowly reinforce to yourself that yes, I'm on the right track, and then start moving deeper and deeper into it.
Okay, Varnika, she says, how do we convince our family members who vehemently object to career change in midlife?
Yeah, I've got a simple exercise for that. Whoever your family members, let's say it's your dad, mom, your spouse, whoever it is. What you do is you tell them that I feel that I need to explore a change. Don't say that I want to change. I'm just doing loud thinking with you that I need to explore a change. And the change that I have thought of so far is 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to become an artist. I want to become a counselor. I want to become a social worker. I want to become a dress designer or whatever it is. Then you ask the person that you please tell me logically why you feel that I should continue in the same profession, and where am I headed, and what do you think I'm going to be achieving if I continue? At the same time, write down the points and tell me what are the negatives that will happen if I give up this profession. What is it that you are apprehensive about? Take your time and then list out and come back and say, yes, I know, I'm aware that these are the hurdles, these are the challenges. This is how I propose to overcome them. Make it a continuous dialogue. Don't get into confrontation with your family members.
Okay, there's Aparna Vinod. She says, hi, Dr. Ali.
Hi, Aparna.
I have decided to pursue a career in UI UX design after working in the IT field as a software developer for 2 years. But how do I get over the fears of not being able to find a job in this new field?
Yeah, right now, don't think of a job. Think of sharpening your skills. Can you quit and get into a full-time course? Ideal. Since you are still young and if you don't have the liability of having to earn for your family. If for whatever reason you can't do it, can you take up a part-time weekend distance learning program in whatever you want to do? Get the feel of it. Then, as I mentioned earlier also, try and see where you can get some sort of internship or some sort of voluntary work or somewhere where you can get some entry level and get a feel of it. Once you do that, you look around and see other people who are in the similar boat, how much they are earning, what has been their career graph and things of that sort. Then when you know that, yes, this seems to be fine, that is the time when you can overcome your fears and take the risk of jumping from one boat to another.
Now, Shakuntala Bhardwaj.
Yes, Shakuntala.
A 40-year-old person says he is a CA and working in finance for 20 years. I am good at my work and skills, but I now see that I am not passionate about it. I know where my passion lies, but it will not fetch enough money for a living. I am the breadwinner of the family, so I am in a position to earn well enough for my child's higher studies, my savings and so on. I feel trapped. Please help.
No, please don't feel trapped. I told you these are the type of things which pull you down so badly that you lose your rationality. You are not trapped. You are a successful professional in the accounts field. You are earning. You have established yourself. You have a reputation. You have a respect. You have earning. Everything you have. But this is not your ultimate calling. If you're 40 years old, think of the next 40 years of your working life. Your son would have grown up, probably your grandson would be requiring fees to go to college by that time, isn't it? So tell yourself it's going to take time. It's just that right now there are constraints. Tomorrow, even if I find something very passionate, as you mentioned, I can't just jump from here to there because I'm not going to be able to earn. But can I start nurturing that talent? Can I start working in that particular area in my free time? And slowly, can I see whether I start earning some money out of it, even as a hobby or part-time or whatever it is? And then sit and do a calculation. Okay, how many years more I need to earn? How much money do I need? How do I ensure my son's education and all those things? Slowly, 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 things will start falling in place. So nothing may happen in the next 6 months, but maybe in 6 years, you'll be ready to take the jump and you will be able to move on. I think we are coming to the last couple of questions because it's nearing time.
Okay, Alice says, teenagers are in unrealistic goal. How can we channelize them?
I don't know, Alice. Sometimes the parents' goals seem more unrealistic to me than the teenagers' goals. What do we define as unrealistic? I know of children who have gone into the most unexpected careers and they are minting money. One of my students, who wanted to be a kabaddi player, today organizes international kabaddi matches and something. He does those events and this and that, and he's on a rough note, he's earning anywhere between 3 to 6 lakhs a month with kabaddi as his profession. Now, at that time, everybody said it is unrealistic. I want you to understand that the world is changing. For today's teenagers, nothing is unrealistic. Just listen to the teenager, explore, make it a teamwork and explore with him what are the options, and you yourself will see. Come to a dialogue and come to an understanding. Last question, Sonal.
Nallapur Madhvi again from Hyderabad.
Yeah.
She says she needs help in her with her son.
Yeah.
Because it's like ghar ki murgi dal barabar.
I know.
MPC student, he's addicted to mobile, don't want to explore.
Yeah, this addiction to mobile and these and that are only symptoms, Madhvi. Don't worry about that. Once a person starts finding a better direction and better things to do, the addiction goes out. Don't even use the word addiction. He is overusing the mobile because he's got nothing better to do. Poor chaps, youngsters of today seem to be really locked in very badly compared to the adults. We have to be a little more sympathetic towards them. At the same time, we need to wean them off, not by policing, not by threatening them, and not by preventing them from using their smartphones or something, but for finding the alternatives and explorations. In fact, that's one of the things that we are doing. We are working on a workshop or a webinar or course for how you can teach life skills to your children away from the screen. So we are just getting ready with that. We will launch that to help parents like you who would like to teach your child life skills away from the screen and give better options so that the child feels attached or attracted towards those new things, and he or she moves on.
She has one more query. She says,
we will answer the queries definitely. So please do get in touch with us. I'm also seeing certain questions coming up on the screen. But as Sonal mentioned, we are very, very particular that we stick to time. We value your time. I'm extremely happy that 99% of you who logged in did not log out. The number has been steady, which shows that you have been involved. You feel that some benefit has come. This will be a continuous process. You are free to get in touch. Seema has just put up our timings and this and that. As soon as the lockdown is lifted, our whole team will be there available in person, on phone or through email. We will answer a lot more questions. It's a continuous process, whether it's for yourself, whether it's for a child, whether it's for your parent, whoever it is. Do keep working on it. Life can be very, very enjoyable if you start taking the right decisions and moving in the right direction. There's wonderful things happening out there. Just be a little more tolerant of these lockdowns and COVIDs and all that. It will pass. and then we'll move on to a much better and a much more happier life, and then we'll all start traveling. Even if we don't make travel into a profession, we are going to then, with vengeance, we are going to get out and we are going to travel and see the whole world. Till then, enjoy yourself, have a wonderful time, have a wonderful day and a wonderful weekend. I will see you again next Saturday at 11 o'clock. Bye-bye.